Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, Tiny and Tidy. I'm Vishali and I am determined to motivate you to get your messy, disorganized space nice and tidy. When it comes to organizing, not only is it important that my home is organized, but I also need to be organized when traveling. When I used to travel on my own or just with my husband, this was a little easier to do. But now that I'm traveling with three little ones, I've had to step up my game. And speaking of little ones, there's Josh crying, I'll be right back. All right, looks like Josh is gonna be joining us in today's video. If you'd like to know some pro packing tips, ones that you can use when traveling with, or even without kids, then keep on watching. And if you just wanna know how you can get more organized in general, things like decluttering and organizing your home, meal planning, creating cleaning and maintenance schedules, keeping your family organized, then watch until the end of this video and I'll tell you more about that. My in-laws live in Montreal and we recently took a road trip to visit them. We went for 5 days and the following are 6 tips that help keep our family of 5 organized. I also wanna mention that if you wanna know where I got any of the products that I mentioned in this video, they will be linked in the description box down below. Tip number one is planning outfits. Before I actually start packing our clothes, I like to really plan what to bring. I don't just grab a bunch of clothes. Instead, I think about each day that we'll be there. What will we most likely be doing? What will the weather be like, etc. And I create outfits for each day. I do the same for the kids, but I add more changes of clothes for them, and I don't expect them to wear something more than once, since it's very likely that they'll get it dirty. As for myself, I will plan outfits that can be worn more than once so that I reduce the amount of items I have to pack. Tip number two is traveling supplies. Keep all of your traveling supplies in one spot. I keep all of our travel size toiletries, packing cubes, adapters, etc. in this under the bed storage organizer. That way, when I'm traveling, I'm not running all around the house looking for what I need. It's all in one designated spot. Tip number three is packing cubes and chew bags. Not only do I use packing cubes when traveling, but I use them to organize at home and even daily in my diaper bag. They really help keep like items together and keep your suitcase tidy. When you get to your destination, you can also easily remove the cubes and put them in the empty drawers, making it very easy to find what you need. As much as I'm not a fan of too much color, I did purchase different colors for our packing cubes. Each family member has a set of cubes in a particular color. That way, if I know I need something for my daughter Isha, I know that it'll be in a purple packing cube. Whereas if it's for Josh, it'll be in an orange one. I'll grab green for Kian, navy for my husband Kieran, and obviously black for myself. I also like using these shoe bags because they're durable and reusable. We also know that they're only used for shoes, so we won't start putting other items in there. And I really like the clear window that allows me to see which pair of shoes is inside without having to open it. Tip number four, toiletries. I love this toiletries bag and I highly recommend it. I've linked it in the description box down below. It has sections which helps keep things organized by category. I also love that it opens up nice and flat so I can easily see everything that's in it. It has a section for my makeup brushes and a pocket for my makeup palette. Which brings me to another tip. If you wear makeup, try to depot your makeup and put it in a makeup palette. It takes up a lot less space and everything you need is in one spot. There are lots of YouTube videos and blog posts that can teach you how to depot your makeup. I also suggest using travel size containers that you can just fill your products into whenever you're traveling. Tip number five, essentials bag. When traveling on an airplane, you usually pack a carry-on that has all of your essentials. The same applies to road trips. I like to pack a separate bag that has everything we'll need for the car ride in one spot. Change of clothes for the kids, diapers, wipes, snacks, etc. I also like to pack our PJs in there since I know that we'll be arriving there at night and that's the first thing that we'll need. When we go to a place like Great Wolf Lodge, for example, I know that our room might not be ready when we get there. So I'll pack all of our bathing suits in our essentials bag so that there's no need to open all of the other bags. Everything we need for the first few hours is in the essentials bag. Tip number six is busy bags. I created a pouch that's filled with different activities that my kids can do when we stop at restaurants. Some places will already have coloring activities that kids can do, but they don't all have them. So it's helpful to have something to keep them busy while they wait. I simply walked around the dollar store and picked out some supplies and created activities. I am a teacher, so coming up with things for them to do is fairly easy. But if you're struggling with coming up with ideas, simply Google busy bags or search on Pinterest, and you'll come across lots of great ideas that you can easily recreate. Earlier, I had mentioned to watch until the end of this video if you want to know more about how to organize your home. So if you're interested in learning how I organize all of the things I need to get done, how do I keep track of everything, how do I schedule it, how do I meal plan, how do I keep track of every family member's schedule, what's my cleaning schedule like, how do I organize every room in my home, and so on, then pay attention. I'm working on an online program called Clear the Clutter that will help you get organized step by step. If you're interested in learning how to organize your home, implement organization systems that actually work, learn how to meal plan, create a detailed home maintenance and cleaning schedule, then sign up on the waitlist for my Clear the Clutter program. The link is in the description box down below. And once the program launches, you will be notified and provided with more information. If you like the tips I shared in this video, follow me on Facebook and Instagram because that's where I share daily tips and tricks all about organization, saving time, and simplifying your life. Next week, I'm going to be explaining how to freshen your bed and lift dirt residue, moisture, and dust mites lurking in your mattress. And you'll get the opportunity to learn how to make a bed that looks and feels like one you'd find in a hotel. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell if you want to know when that video is posted. And if you like this video, be sure to check out one of these ones. They're full of tips and tricks that will help you get more organized. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and happy tidying. Bye!